Barabara ni muhimu kwa sababu inatusaidia kuendesha kilimo, kuendesha biashara, kuendesha uchumi na kufanya mambo ya usafiri kuwa rahisi.
Kwa hii finance bill inakuja, sasa tutaweka barabara zingine lami vile tumeweka hii. Na mimi nataka niwaeleze na nataka mnisikize vizuri. Si hapa kukikuwa na barabara wakulima wataweza kupeleka mazao yao sokoni. Ni kweli si kweli? Sijui kama tunaelewana. Now, not to talk about how much the president spent in fuel for his guzzlers together with the DP from Nairobi up to here. I'm here. This is Mau Mau Road Lot 2, Murang'a County. As you can see hapo ni Kenha. But there's something I want you to see up there. Project number Kenha 2205/2019. So I've only one question to our president. Kama project number kwa Kenha ni ya 2019, how did he manage to launch it in 2023? In 6 months' time, the stadium in Kamarini, which is historic, will be complete. I am at AIC Kamarini. AIC Kamarini is next to Kamarini Stadium. This is Elgeyo Marakwet County. Na mambo ni jinsi ambavyo nimekuonyesha. Machozi, machozi tupu.
Hello guys, I hope you are all doing fine. So, interestingly, today State House took its time to reply to Lawyer Mora Kebaso. So, those who don't know about Lawyer Mora is a furniture dealer and a lawyer. Ed, Lawyer Mora embarked on a nationwide tour, not just a normal tour, but a tour to inspect dead government projects. This comes after President William Ruto made a nationwide tour to launch development projects in various constituencies. Many Kenyans realized that these projects that were launched by President William Ruto were not original projects that, you know, have the process of being drafted, public participation, and so on. They realize that majority of the projects that President William Ruto is going around the country, you know, building a milestone that he can use to run for presidency in 2027, that majority of them were projects by the former president, Uhuru Kenyatta. From that point of concern, embarked on a nationwide tour to inspect that indeed, if this project were launched, whether they are completed, and if not completed, what's the nature of the progress. And today we have seen State House in X, formerly known as Twitter, responding to Mora Kebaso allegations that indeed government has failed to deliver the projects maximumly, meaning that the projects that are being launched by President William Ruto are not completed, and many of them are dead. The State House reply emphasized to Mora Kebaso not to focus on the breaks of the project, but to focus on the progress of the project. So, according to the reply, indeed, State House is like using reverse psychology, like trying to discourage Mora Kebaso from doing what he is doing best in inspecting and, you know, informing Kenyans of the dead projects that President William Ruto and other politicians, you know, come bragging that, you know, indeed, in a certain, you know, constituency or ward, there's a road that is ongoing. And an MP can use that road, you know, to market himself, to have good public relations for 5 years. And Kenyans are wondering, are these the same roads we had Uhuru Kenyatta launching? We are hearing also President William Ruto is launching. What do you think, according to the State House reply, that, you know, Kebaso, you know, Mora should focus not on breaks, but the history of the project? What do you think? Do you think that, you know, it was necessary for State House to reply? Do you think, like, the reply of the State House is convincing you as a citizen? What do you think about it? Do you think that Mora should stop or should continue doing what he is doing best in making sure he is keeping government to its toes and making sure that the service providers and the contractors of the projects deliver to Kenyans?
Now that I've decided I don't want a political position, wacha niwadunge reality. Gloves off. Most of you Kenyans deserve bad leadership. Most of you Kenyans deserve your poverty. Most of you Kenyans deserve your disenfranchisement. In fact, mnafaa muibiwe proper. Inafaa muendelee kuporwa paka muishe. You deserve it. Even if you voted for Raila, si ameingia kwa serikali. Si wanaenda kuiba pamoja na Ruto. You deserve everything that you're going to get. Because since we came out as a generation kujaribu kuchange mambo, intention yetu asiretu hata ikuwa na individuals ati na William Ruto ama Raila ama nini. We just wanted to change the systems so that we can have working systems which can hold people accountable. So that hata tukichagua mtu, hata akienda abadilike, the systems are strong enough kumtema inje. Lakini nyinyi mkaleta ukabila. Mkasema asante sana rais, umetuchagulia mtu wetu kwa cabinet. Wacha mtu wako akusaidie. Kama ukuwa na kazi, si umechaguliwa cabinet secretary kutoka kwa kabila yako, akupe kazi. Kama shida ulikuwa unafungiwa nyumba, si umechaguliwa cabinet secretary kutoka kwa kabila yako, akulipie, akujazie gas. Si ni wenu, ama sio nyinyi mlisema, si nyinyi ndio mlisema ni mwizi lakini ni wetu. Ya, mwizi wako akusaidie. Acha mwizi wako akusaidie.
Watu wa Makueni hamjambo. Hamjambo tena.
Hatujambo.
Mimi nilikuwa hapa tarehe 27 mwezi wa 5 mwaka 2017. Ni kweli si kweli?
Ni kweli.
Sasa nimerudi hapa tena. Na nitaweka tena mpango ingine ya hii Water Stadium Makueni County ambayo ilikuwa na 1500 capacity stadiums. Sijui kama tunaelewana. Tulikuwa tumeweka 299 million. Hiyo ni karibu milioni 300 kwa hii mradi. Tayari tumekwisha lipa contractor 126 million. Sijui kama tunaelewana. Sasa kukijengwa stadium hapa, hawa mama mboga hawa, na hawa watu makanga, na hawa vinyozi, na wale wabeba beba, sasa hawa wote wataweza kufurahia manufaa ya hii stadium. Sijui kama tunaelewana. Nataka niwaeleze hivi. Tunataka amani katika taifa letu. Hatutaki fujo. Hatutaki siasa ya maandamano. Sijui kama mnanisikia hapa. Watu wa Magweni mnasemaje? Situpange hii kazi. Situlete kila mtu ndani ya serikali ya makabila yote. Bas, mimi nimekuja hapa. Sasa hii mradi nitafungua tena. Na tena hapa kando hapa. Nitaweka mradi ya housing units. Hapa kwa hii fence hii. Tayari hapo tushaweka mpango. Tutajenga hapo housing units ambazo hawa vijana ambao hawana kazi wataweza kununua. Na hawa wafanyikazi wa serikali ambao wanatoza ushuru usiku na mchana, sasa wataweza kununua hizi nyumba ambazo tunataka kujenga hapa. Sijui kama tunaelewana. Salale. Kweli nyinyi ni watu mmejielewa. So I'm here at Water Stadium in Makueni County to see where 126 million money ya wa Kenya imetumika. Sasa, in a couple of months, the stadium in Wote will be complete. Bas, that was 2017 when he said that. Ndio hii. Mambo ni live. So in this episode of the Vampire Diaries, I've already shown you the Water Stadium. Now, just opposite the Water Stadium, my cameraman is going to show you. The Water Stadium is that fence that you see there. He's going to zoom it in for you. So that fence that you see there, that is Water Stadium. Now, directly opposite it, the bush has already been cleared. His Excellency President William Ruto now wants to build affordable housing. He will come here very soon to launch this one, affordable housing. Now, I want you to see what we have down here, just next to where he wants to build his affordable housing projects. Just look. Look at those houses. Those are several blocks of houses that were built long time ago. I don't know whether it's during Moi's time or Kibaki's time, but a long, long time ago. Some of them, they are in a state of disrepair, but I believe they can be renovated. Because easy blocks is equal 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 18, 19, 20. They're like 20 blocks here, residential blocks. I believe hizi ni zile zikwanga zinajengewa civil servants. So now let me ask you guys. If William Ruto is interested in being our president, if he indeed is interested in governance, Why build affordable housing here when you have incomplete houses there?